The Rhodesian nationalist leader, Bishop Ivor Mills, has accepted Mr. Smith's offer to negotiate an internal settlement based on one man, one vote. But, he says, there are conditions. These include stopping the execution of all captured prisoners of war. In Australia, Mr. Kerry Packer's cricketers are still pending the right. Yes, it's a high court decision. It's a different plan on them playing in test matches.
This is the voice of Allah, representative of the Ashtar Galactic Commander, speaking to you. For many years, you have seen us as knights and sailors. We speak to you now to say the same as we have done to your brothers and sisters all over this, your planet Earth. We come to warn you of the destiny of your race and your world so that you may commit to your fellow beings the course you must take to avoid the disaster which threatens your world and the beings on other worlds around you. This is an order that you may share in great awakening as the planet passes into the new age of Aquarius. The new age can be a time of great peace and liberation for your race, but only if your rulers are made aware of safety, forces that cannot control their judgments. Be still, Noro, and restore, for your chance may not come again. All your weapons of evil must be removed. The time for conflict is now past, and the race of which you are a part may proceed to the higher stages of its evolution, if you show yourselves worthy to do this. You have but a short time to learn to live together in peace and goodwill. Small groups all over the planet are learning this, and exist to pass on the light of the dawning new age to you all. You are free to accept the
rejection. Don't make such a kitchen point to make one of this one. Many go as wide as one. Then they run out.
Here now, the voice of Rimmon, representative of the Ashtar Galactic Command, speaking to you. Be aware also that there are many false prophets and guides of this operating on your planet. They will suck your energy from you, the energy you call money, and will put it to evil ends, giving you worthless costs in return. Your inner divine self will protect you from this. You must not to be sensitive to the voice of him that can tell you what is true and what is wrong. Learn to listen to the voice of truth.
Such as a
this is our message.
We really appreciate that we can. I insist on the little full of only really charged radiums. I can
that's had nine lives.
Have no fear. Keep on looking at yourself and discover with the wings of your planet Earth. We see the Ashtar Galactic Command thanks to your attention. We are not leaving the planes of your existence. May you be blessed out of the supreme north of untrampled mountains.
We understand that viewers in some parts of the region are receiving a breakthrough in sound. We're sorry about this, and we're doing our best to rectify the fault.
Finally back home, engineers are trying to trace the source of what they call a rogue transmission, which lasted about 6 minutes during ITN's early evening news bulletin. It affected viewers in the Berkshire and Hampshire area served by the Hannington transmitter. They heard a voice which cut across what I was reading. The voice said, "Earthlings, lay down your arms. This is a message from outer space." Well, thousands of viewers later phoned Southern Television, the police, and ITN here. A spokesman for the Independent Broadcasting Authority said, "This is the first incident of its kind in Britain." Winchester police said some people were frightened by the hoax message. They said they sent an officer to calm down one woman. Well, I hope nothing's interrupted this bulletin wherever you are this evening. From all of us here, good night.
Independent Radio News at 12, David Geary. The Independent Broadcasting Authority is at a loss to explain the mysterious message that broke into a Southern Television news broadcast. The slow, deep voice proclaimed, in part, "All your weapons of evil must be destroyed. You only have a short time to learn to live in peace." The station was immediately besieged by worried telephone callers demanding an explanation. But as the information officer for the Broadcasting Authority, John Ginnery, says, there could be several different causes of the message.
Well, we don't know for sure that it was a pirate call. We know that there were some voices over saying certain things of which we haven't got an exact record. We've had a lot of accounts, obviously. A lot of people have been phoning us and other people about it. We simply don't know what it was. Broadcasts, of course, are monitored at an operation centre. But there was simply a mumble, and there was some picture distortion. We had a lot of reports in, but as I say, we simply don't know what it was.
Independent Radio News, it's 3 minutes past 12.